We are looking at the brand new OC-5 octave pedal from Boss. And just before we get into the video, I would like to be super clear that Boss are not paying me to make this video. I just like making cool videos with things that make cool sounds. So if you're new to the channel, that is what these videos are all about. And we shall get to some music, but first, let's start the show. I've always been an OC-2 guy, as I'm sure you are well aware. And I skipped the OC-3, and here we are with the brand new OC-5 from Boss. Let's take a listen to both of these pedals side by side. Let's see if the OC-5 does what it claims to do, which is recreate the OC-2 in vintage mode. And then let's see how useful the new poly mode is. You'll hear it with this exact setting. This is the JoJo Mayer setting that John Davis, that Tim LaFave, that a bunch of people always use on the old OC-2. It is octave one all the way up and then octave two all the way down and no dry signal, no natural sound of the bass. Now, what do we do as bass players? We play with drummers. If we're really lucky, we play with great drummers. Here we are in 2020, the middle of a global pandemic. I couldn't bring a drummer over here, but I do have some Nate Smith loops from the Loop Loft, and I've pre-recorded some examples of me using, again, both pedals, OC-2, OC-5, back-to-back, playing along with Nate Smith. All the information's on the screen. Same setting all the way through that we've been using so far, the JoJo Mayer setting. We'll be right back. Okay, so that's how I like to use my OC-2. That's how I would use the OC-5 if this was on my pedal board. I want to love it. I want the new stuff to be better than the old stuff. I want technological advancement to also equal musical satisfaction. But in terms of having a true analog circuit and giving me what the OC-2 does, despite the fact that this is a stronger signal, is probably a little more definition in the sound. For my ear, for my feeling, the feeling I get off the strings and with the air moving in the room and the sound coming out of the amp, there's maybe a little bit of a mid punch in here, very, very slight. It is, at the end of the day, an incredibly close digital representation of an analog OC-2 circuit. And you really can't complain about that. It's exactly what Boss have said they're doing with this pedal, and that is exactly what it does. So one of the things I was pretty psyched to try out with this pedal is the poly mode. That's the new addition to the unit, and I have it basic poly mode for the first time using any kind of Boss octave pedal. I'm actually blending in some clean signals, some direct level. I've taken out the -1 octave all the way, and I'm at about 12 o'clock with the +1 octave, and I'm at around 1:32 o'clock with the range knob. So that's the basic setting that you're hearing right now. And ooh, okay, so there's my first chord. And I was just really curious about how well it was going to cope, especially with a bass guitar with chords. And I've noticed that it's not so bad with chords that aren't that complex. This is just a straight major chord, root 5, root 10th. But as soon as you introduce a tension or something a little bit farther away from the regular 1-3-5, I'm just adding a 9 here, starting to get some issues of modulation, quite clean, add the 9. Kind of warbling a little bit. And just very quickly, it's very strange for me to describe sounds with words. So my warble might be your wobble, for instance. My grit might be your grime. I don't know. So just take all the phrases with a pinch of salt. This is just how I feel it. And right now, if I have spread triads, for instance, in the upper register of the instrument, it's not too bad. There's not a lot of modulation there at all, and it's handling the audio. It's okay. I wouldn't say that it was a very inspiring sound, and I wonder if this is because this is aimed perhaps more at guitar players. I am in the bass mode on the little toggle switch on the back, but just the fact that a guitar plays up in that range, closer to that range, it's not leaping so many octaves. Maybe that's really what causes the issue when we get any kind of poly mode in a pedal. You know, the Electro-Harmonix Pog, the TC Electronic Sub and Up, they all kind of sound in this basic zone, timbre zone. You know, I like to have a little bit of delay when I'm playing to give the sound some space. You almost get kind of a dirty organ sound. But again, I'm playing very simple triads here. As soon as I start to add some tensions, then we're really getting some serious modulation, which I'm not opposed to. I just like to be able to be in control of that and perhaps add that from a different source. And how are we with minor triads? Yeah, not so bad with minor triads, but we get a nice full chord. And we're definitely getting a lot of modulation there, which I could kind of do without. So for me, that doesn't make it very usable at all, unfortunately. You know, crunchy chords like a minor 13 with the 7, so we have a major 7 interval in there. The tracking is not bad, I will say that. But but then it's not really the exact sound I want to hear and want to feel under my fingers when I'm playing up in that register. Anyone who knows my playing, you'll have heard of the baby elephant sound before. It's basically a simple pitch. It is not poly, but it is a simple pitch which goes up. It goes up a few octaves. And it's just a little smoother. There's less modulation in there. The tracking is very good. And I will say the tracking isn't... tracking isn't bad in the OC-5. I just get the impression it's more of a guitar effect than it is a bass effect. So where the poly mode may not be my favorite feature of the pedal, a big win and something I think has a lot of musical potential is the ability to turn the range, our far right knob here, turn the range knob all the way down in poly mode. Now I have about 1 o'clock in terms of the direct signal. I've taken all the upper octave completely out, so the whole higher register thing is off. And I'm at about 10 o'clock with the minus one octave. So with that range turned all the way down to the lowest setting, I'm basically able to play chords and only have the lower octave applied to the lowest note. Now I'm still getting used to the touch. I don't know exactly where the sweet spot is. And you have to be super accurate with your technique in the right hand, plucking all the notes at the same time. I think that's kind of how it's going to work the best. And maybe 3-note chords as opposed to 4. As I said, I'm still finding the sweet spot. But what it does is give me that super clean upper structure part of the voicing, like this, or... and I've turned it off now, of course, just to show you what my bass sounds like without any of the octave on it. And I'm playing this chord. I'm playing a first inversion major triad here, for instance. So A over C sharp. And what I'm going to get when I put the OC-5 on is this note down here, but keeping the real cleanliness of the notes on the top of the chord. Of course, it's not perfect in terms of a musical continuity sense, because like there, for instance, I'm playing a suspension of fourth going to a third on a major triad. But when I go to play the second melody note, I'm not playing the lowest note with my thumb again, because really I just want that to ring on. So it's recognizing the lowest note of the chord as the fifth, instead of the root. So it's going to take a while to find the sweet spot, but I do see a bunch of musical potential there, especially with looping and being able to make a hugely fat groove from the get-go rather than having to play chords and then layer a bass line. Could be really great for live playing, for improvising, for composition. I think for me, as a new feature set, that's kind of the winning thing with this pedal. I gotta say, I'm not crazy about the OC-2 circuit. If I'm gonna have an OC-2 on my board, it's probably gonna be an OC-2. I'm crazy about them. It's something that's very personal, again. But at $129.99 US dollars, I believe they are over here, you can't really go wrong, because it is unbelievably close to the old OC-2. So if you're not particularly bothered about having the vintage pedal, which, by the way, cost an absolute fortune now on Reverb or eBay or wherever you're going to try and find one. They're not cheap at all. You might pay double the price of the OC-5 to get a good version of an old Octaver with the R on it. This color, 1982 OC-2 made in Japan, it really might cost you a bit of a fortune, and you're not going to get any of the other features in the pedal. So there are wins, there are losses for me, and I think, as always, it comes down to what you want out of the pedal. Do you really, like a lot of people want, do you want something that's just gonna track your bass in all registers of the instrument? Because if so, it does a great job of that. It will track all the way down here. I got it sounding an open E, without breaking up. I'm not sure how useful an open E, like an octave below your open E string, really is, but it definitely tracks there. To me, it starts getting useful around a B flat to a B, C, somewhere in that register of the instrument. It starts really getting useful in terms of a usable note. But for me, it's more about subharmonic when you go kind of A chromatically down through E. Then you're getting into the territory of a DOD FX32 meatbox, something that's a subharmonic rather than an octave pedal. And the other thing is, do you really need to go flying around the upper register of the instrument with the octave on? Probably not. Maybe it's fun. Either way, it does track very, very well. If you want that, it's totally there. And that is with a little bit of clean signal in there as well. Just to give it a little bit of definition in the sound for playing a kind of more rhythmically dense material. And then, can you have fun with it? That's the biggest question. That's the one I'm always asking first. You know, I have my rig here. I've got the Bug Crusher. I've got the Maris, the Autobit Junior. And that's with the OC-5, and it feels good, especially combined with other effects. It's not crushing the Bug Crusher. It's not overwhelming the Maris, the OC-5. I'm in active mode right now, and it isn't being overwhelmed by that either. And at the end of the day, that's what you want. You want something that works great. You don't have to think about it technically. It's easy to use. It does exactly what it says on the box, and you can make music with it. Those are the only things that I want out of a pedal. Is this gonna make it on my board because of the poly mode? Probably not. That's not for me. I think poly mode in general for bass is a little bit, it's just kind of not there yet. I think we're a little far away from making that sound good and making that sound less like a Pog or a Sub and Up or the OC-5 here. I really think we need something that's a little more neutral, a little cleaner, a nicer starting point that doesn't freak out when we get to complex chords and when we get to kind of, you know, more rhythmically dense music and melodic and linear content. But in terms of being able to make textures, in terms of being a workhorse pedal in your pedal board, I've got to say, it does that. It absolutely does that. And especially if you don't want to spend twice the amount of money on a pedal that does half as much stuff or less than half as much stuff, this is a totally solid option. It is a digital circuit at the end of the day. It's a digital pedal, and you get what you pay for, right? I've subtly campaigned whenever I've had the ear of anyone at Boss, I've subtly campaigned for there being an OC-2 Wazza. I really still think that's what they should have done. That's just my opinion. I would have loved to have seen an all analog pedal. Yes, it would have been more expensive. They perhaps would have sold less. Maybe it wouldn't have been as hugely popular as I'm sure this is going to be. But I think that probably still needs to happen at some point. I think there are still enough people who care about it being an analog circuit and retaining, you know, even more character of what is such an iconic pedal in the history of all pedals. Basically, this thing is huge. This thing is an absolute icon. It's the brown box. It's something I'll probably never be without, and it's something I think really one day deserves the Wazza treatment, I think. So leave me some comments. Let me know what you think about this. Maybe you have one already. I'm a little late to the party in terms of checking it out, making a video, posting it to YouTube. Don't forget to hit the like button if you dig what you're hearing, and make sure you subscribe to the channel. I'm gonna play out of this video with the OC-5 in vintage mode using the JoJo Mayer setting. It's going into the Frederick's Effect Bug Crusher, and also using a little bit of Maris Otto Bit Junior and a touch of delay on the end of the signal chain. Thanks for sticking around to the end of the video. Hope you dig what you're seeing and you're hearing, and I'll see you again on the next one.